Microbes have ruled the world for billions of years, but most people wouldn't have any idea how important or vital they are for life on Earth. In fact, the human body has 10 times as many microbial cells in and on it at any moment as it has human cells. They have the potential to mitigate climate change, control diseases, generate alternative energy sources, and be responsible for multi-million dollar industries. And all this from the smallest living organisms on Earth. Microbes are comprised of protozoa, bacteria, fungi, viruses, and several other single-celled microscopic life forms. The most amazing thing is that if we took all of the living things from the ocean and weighed those creatures, 90% of that weight is comprised of microbes.
Sponges have really intimate associations with marine microbes. So at Ames, what we're really trying to look at now is how climate change, and in particular elevated sea temperatures, are going to affect that delicate balance between the sponge and its symbionts. Microbes play a lot of important roles for the health of the sponge. They're involved in feeding and nutrition. They help with the reproduction and the chemical defence and the immunity of the sponge. What we've found here at Ames is that there's this temperature threshold of about 33 degrees where things start to go wrong inside the sponge. So we see a loss of those really helpful bacteria and the introduction of some microbes which have been associated with disease.
Although the vast majority of microbes are beneficial, there are a few that are detrimental, and those detrimental ones will cause disease of many marine species, including corals and sponges.
One of the diseases we're most interested in is White syndrome. And White syndrome results in rapid tissue loss, and it's quite widespread and quite lethal for corals. We've been particularly interested in the bacterium that causes White syndrome and found that there is one specific bacterium which is related to cholera that causes diseases within humans.
To work out what causes the disease, we take healthy corals and we add bacteria that we think may be causing the disease. We add it to the tank and then we wait to see if disease signs show up on the coral. And if they do, it gives us an indication that those bacteria are actually causing the disease itself.
We're really in the very early stages of marine microbiology research, and what we're already discovering is a huge diversity of microbes new to science, and what role those microbes play, whether they're helpful or harmful in the marine environment, is going to be the topic for future research here at Ames.
The study of microbes is really like the next gold rush, but it's going to be a lot more valuable than gold.